Hey everyone, it's Saturday, June the 8th, and today I'm going to run up to the Rangiwahia Hut, and from there I'm going to continue on and complete the Dead Man's Loop. All up the Dead Man's Loop track return to the car park is about 17 kilometres, and from the car park to the hut is about 3.5 kilometres, I think. So the track leading up to the hut is a really nice graded gravel trail, which is runnable and perfect for new trail runners. If you wonder what it looks like, watch the video and you'll know exactly what it looks like. Also, you will see the spectacular Rangiwahia Arch Bridge in the video. It's pretty cool, and from looking at it, I still wonder how they put it there. But enjoy the video. Thanks. I know the first couple of k's on this track is really nice, up to the hut and back. It makes a nice little hike. I've had to speed up a bunch of these clips to try and shorten up the whole video, so it's made the quality of the footage a bit blurry in places, but probably better than watching 25 minutes of me running along these trails. Once you reach this point, you'll notice a couple of signs, one pointing further up, which will take you on to complete the Dead Man's Loop. Back down this track, you will see the hut, and to my left, the track cuts away, and there's a lookout. So this is a pretty awesome hut, and on a fine day up here, the view is absolutely incredible. Looking out towards Ruapeho, all the way around back towards Kapiti. You can see quite a long way on a clear day. This is a well equipped hut, and there is further around the corner you'll see a woodshed.
That's just a lookout up there. There's nothing up there. It's a woodshed. Oh, that water's cold.
Moving on from here, the track isn't a graded gravel track anymore. It turns into a mountain trail, and you have to be careful to follow the markers and stuff. So from here on up, if you're not an experienced runner, it may not be a good idea to go up here unless it was a very fine day. I hope you enjoyed watching. Soon after this, my phone ran out of battery and I wasn't able to keep filming.